When you start with WordPress, you will want to brand your website and give it a personal touch. A good way to begin customizing your website is with the settings in the admin menu. In this video, I will show you the general settings that allow you to edit your title and tagline, edit your URL, manage the registrations, choose the language of the site, and set the time and date format. We start in the dashboard, then click on the settings menu item in the admin menu. This will open the general settings screen. The first thing you can do in the general settings screen is give your site a title. The site title does not have to be the same as the site name in the URL. In this case, we already have a title, and I will leave it like this. To preview the site name as it appears on the site, first, click the Save Changes button at the bottom of the screen if you made any changes. Then, click on the title of the page in the toolbar. Your site will open, and you will see how the title appears. Note that the title is shown in the tab here as well. Next to the title of the page, there is also the tagline. To edit the tagline, we go back to the General Settings screen. We add the new tagline in the box here by simply typing it out. It is advisable to be concise and precise here, so you can get your message across as clear as possible. Search engines also index your site and tagline, so make sure to make them relevant and increase your chances of ranking better. For example, I will put something like "Learning about the world through travel" here. We repeat the same procedure as before. First we click Save, and then we click on the title of the page to see the change. In this example, the site title and the tagline are in the header. Note that depending on the theme you use, this may differ. Now that you have that covered, let's go back to see what else you can do in the general settings screen. Below the tagline, there are two boxes, both related to the URL. The first one refers to the WordPress address. This is the address that shows where you installed WordPress and where your WordPress files are stored. In our case, this is http://everydayimtraveling.local. And the other one is the address of the site, and in our case, that is the same. Okay, let's see what other options are in this screen. Add your email address if you want to receive notifications from WordPress whenever someone posts a comment or registers on your site. To enable people to register an account on your site, all you need to do is tick the Anyone Can Register box. With this setting enabled, people will be able to register through the login screen. If you allow registrations, there are various roles you can assign. You can manage these through the new User Default Role menu. We will tell you about the user roles in more detail in Module 6. For now, it is enough to know that you can keep the subscriber option if you plan to allow anyone to register on your site. Subscribers will be able to access their profile and edit it, but they will not have any administrative rights in your backend. Contributors, authors, editors, and administrators have more rights, ranging from simply being able to write posts in the backend, which is the role of a contributor, to full control in the backend, which is the role of the administrator. Finally, the last few options in the general settings are related to language and time. The language option regulates the main language of both your public site and the backend. Click on the menu here to reveal the available languages. Choose the one you want by clicking on it. Click Save. You see that the language is now changed in this screen, as well as the admin menu. Click on the site name, and you see that the language of the menus on the front end changed as well. Let's go back and change back the language to the default and move on. The time zone option is handy if you want your visitors to be able to see, for example, when someone published a comment. Click on the menu, and you will see the UTC options. If you are unsure about your time zone, scroll up and choose a city. If your city is not listed, choose a city that is closest to where you live. For example, I'm located in Wijchen, the Netherlands, but Wijchen is not in the list, so I choose the closest city, which is Amsterdam. Use the date and time format options to choose how dates and time will appear on your site. Either click on the radio button next to the preferred format, or add a custom one in the box here. The final option in the general settings is the week. Use this option if you want to feature a calendar on your site. Then you can choose the date that the calendar will start with. So we saw how you can personalize your site with a title and a tagline. We also saw how to edit the URL, what you can do with registrations on your page, and how to set the language, time, and date on your site. In the next video, we will explore the writing and the reading tabs from the settings menu item.